Hello, welcome to a RioForce tutorial. Today, I'm going to be talking about the best cameras for stop motion animation. So let's say you want to get into stop motion, but you have no idea where to start. Well, that's pretty easy, I'll tell you. With a camera. Well, I mean, you're probably going to need something to actually animate first, but we'll start with the camera, and then we'll move on to the other one in another video. So there are three main types of cameras that you can use for stop motion animation. Phones, webcams, and DSLRs. Now, some people use camcorders or other types of cameras, but those aren't really mainstream, so I'm not going to talk about those in this video. However, for phones, webcams, and DSLRs, I will be providing pros and cons as well as recommendations for all of the above. So let's get started. First off, phones. Let's say you have a phone or a tablet and you want to get into stop motion. Well, there you go. You've already got your camera and your software, basically. Because most phones, or smart devices, tablets, whatever, have cameras on them, and you can use that to animate. But how do you animate, you ask? Well, you can use apps within the phone, like Stop Motion Studio Pro, or others, to take pictures in sequence, and then it plays them back, like stop motion software should. So if you've already got your smartphone or tablet, you've got basically an all-in-one package. That's one of the main pros of using a smartphone for stop motion animation. It's really easy to obtain because a lot of people have phones and tablets nowadays, and it's really easy to use because apps are really easy and you don't have to have an extra computer. You don't have to have anything extra, just the phone. And that's basically it. Like you might want to build a rig to hold the phone up, which you can see in my other video, by the way, but essentially, a phone is an all-in-one package. Some other pros that phones and tablets have, the cameras are pretty decent. I mean, a lot of, especially newer ones, people disregard phones as not being good quality, but they are good quality. I mean, even if they're not good quality, if it takes pictures in a sequence, you can make an animation. Think back to a few years ago, before DSLRs became popular in amateur stop motion, people were using their webcams or whatever they had to make brick films or animations, and the stories they told were still good, and even better maybe than some things that we see today with really good quality camera. So it's not really about the camera quality that you should worry about, I'd say, but what you're making and does it work for making something. Smartphones also have lens options, which you're like, wait, what? Smartphones have lenses? I don't have an iPhone 12 Pro X that has like three cameras. I don't know. No, actually, you can go to Amazon and you can look up these little smartphone lenses that you clip to the back of your phone, and suddenly you have a wide-angle lens, you have a telephoto lens, and so phones suddenly become a more versatile stop-motion tool when you add these extra lenses. Of course, there are some drawbacks to using phones. Like I said, the quality does differ from phone to phone or tablet to tablet. The poor quality, you might not like that, and that might not be what you want, so if you don't, sorry, that's one of the things that phones have. A phone can often be a little difficult to use if you don't like have a remote shutter, or you know, if you're using a tablet and it's really big, it would be hard to fit into a small animation set. And smartphones, they can be difficult to use in some lighting, dark lighting, or like some LED lights. You can have a banding issue where these bars come up on the screen and roll. Another con would be that your smartphone might not support manual focus or manual exposure or whatever through the apps. And in that case, it would be very difficult to use that device for stop motion because then the settings would not be consistent and you couldn't get, I mean, you'd have a lot of light flicker. iPhones, they're the best, I mean, in my opinion, but they can be expensive and that's the problem. So I don't recommend going out and buying a smartphone just for animation. That's pointless. I mean, for how much you pay for an iPhone, there's a lot of different options out there. So those are the things to consider whenever you want to use a smartphone for animation. For more about smartphones, I've already made a video about this that's way more in depth than this. I recommend you check it out. There's a link in the comments in the description and maybe in a card and the end card. Webcams. So, what's the pros and cons about webcams? Well, webcams are usually used nowadays in like Zoom meetings and online classes and stuff. So an external webcam can be used for stop motion animation because pretty small. I mean, they're mobile. Like you can fit them into a small set and move them around, and they have pretty decent close focus. And most of them do have manual focus actually. So the size and the mobility of it, that's one of the main pros that people like about webcams. You could get really close and be in the action instead of being out and observing it. Another pro would be that it connects to the computer, it's got lots of good software, like Boats Animator, or Stop Motion Studio for the computer, Mac and PC, iStopMotion, and a bunch of others. I'll probably make a list in the description for you for more software related to webcams. A lot of new webcams have decent quality, especially if you get a Logitech. I recommend the C920 because that's the gold standard of webcams, essentially. Also, many webcams are under $100, so you can essentially get a C920 for around $70, I would say. So webcams are arguably the least expensive type of camera you can get for stop motion animation if you're going to buy a new camera just for it. But of course, there are cons. Webcams can be poor quality. I mean, if you don't have a Logitech C920, you might be stuck with some cheap Walmart brand, and then it wouldn't be so great to use. However, remember, quality doesn't matter as much as storytelling and animation, in my opinion. Another con would be is that it connects to a computer. So if you don't have already a computer, a laptop, desktop, or something that you can use software, especially a Mac or a PC, or maybe a Linux, but like Chromebooks would not work with this. So you need a computer that can have software in order to use a webcam for stop motion. Another con is limited lenses. Unlike phones, they don't have clip-on lenses. And also webcams, just like phones, are difficult to use in some lighting. They can have banding with LED lights. They can have low light issues. It's just the nature of rolling shutter video and taking pictures through a webcam. However, webcams are essentially the gold standard for what people use in stop motion animation, and it has been for years for the reason that it's small, it's mainly inexpensive, and you know, they're good enough quality. So I recommend, personally, if you get anything out of this list, like if you don't already have it, a webcam, get a webcam, because a webcam will probably do you better. DSLRs. Why would you get a DSLR? Because of the good quality camera. It's really good quality, like it's professional, right? It looks good, it's clear, it's good in low lighting. You can get like fancy depth of field and blurry background and all kinds of good stuff with a DSLR. That's a great reason to get one. I mean, that's why I have one, because I like my videos to look high quality. Another reason that you would get a DSLR is because of different lenses. In a DSLR, you can change out the lens, but there's thousands of lenses you can use on a DSLR. So personally, I have a handful of lenses, telephoto, wide angle, and a few in-betweens. And so that's one of my favorite things about DSLRs is that I can change the lenses out. I can have different style shots, and I can play with cinematography more than the other two options because I have the option to do that. Some cons though, DSLRs are crazy expensive. Now you might find better deals, but for if you want to buy new or if you want to buy higher end cameras, you're gonna look into 600, 700, 1,000 or more. And that's just for the body. But have you thought about lenses? Okay, it comes with one lens, but that's not the best lens to use for stop motion. So you're gonna have to have a variety of lenses if you start getting different lenses. And obviously lenses are not required if you have the one kit lens, but it's really easy to get caught up in the gear. And it keeps getting expensive from there because what are you gonna put your DSLR on? I mean, you can set it on a table to do stop motion, but is that the best option? Personally, I use a tripod and it's separated from the table and it's, you know, weighted. So it's not a cheap Walmart tripod, so it doesn't fall apart and break my camera. And then you go into AC adapters or extra batteries because your camera's gonna run out of battery if you're just using it all the time. So you have to get an AC adapter to plug it into the wall. So all these accessories and things you're gonna want and or whatever, and that adds up cost. So the DSLR option is not just the cost of the body with one lens, because you can't get away with just doing that essentially, or else you'll have a lot of trouble and it would have just been, you know, worth it just to buy a webcam instead because they're easier to use. Another reason why you maybe should not get a DSLR is because software is expensive. There's not very many people that make free software for DSLR stop motion capture. Essentially, you're gonna need a more expensive software. There's varieties of software like Animator HD or DragonFrame, which is essentially the gold standard for stop motion animation programs, but DragonFrame's $400. That's a lot of money. That's like as much as the camera, right? You can get away with using things like Digicam Control for tethering your camera, but it's not really great for stop motion. It's just for taking pictures, essentially. So you're gonna have to require software, and with software, you're gonna need to require a computer. Again, taking pictures with just the camera, you can't cycle through them, you can't play them back, you have to take the SD card out and put it in the computer in order to sync your photos up, and that would cause a lot of problems. That's not really optimal for making animation. DSLRs are clunky. Like I mentioned already, you put them on a tripod whenever I want to take pictures because it doesn't fit into small sets or spaces, especially with different lenses. So, RioForce, you're talking a lot about DSLRs, but which one do you use? Personally, I use a Canon SL1. I don't think you can buy an SL1 anymore because it's a few years old, but something similar to that is what I recommend. Just whatever the cheapest Canon DSLR is, buy that. If it's a T2i, a T6, an SL1, those are all good cameras. A Canon body is essentially the same throughout. So, you know, take that with a little grain of salt because I'm a little biased because I didn't like my Nikon when I had it. Essentially, the main point I want to hammer in here, you don't need a DSLR to get started in stop motion. Use your phone, use your webcam, or use your DSLR if you have one. But if you're going to buy anything new, don't buy anything expensive to start. Start out simple and start out strong on storytelling, animation principles, lighting principles, and things like that before upgrading camera quality. So I hope you learned something in this today. I think I got a little rambly a little bit in there. If you disagree with my opinions, please tell me below. I would love to hear your thoughts about this. And if you need anything else, I am in the comments. So just ask questions away and subscribe, please, for more stop motion animations and stop motion tutorials in the future. Thank you very much.